Dalvin Cook. Those are the only two words you really need to describe the Minnesota Vikings, because Chef Dalvin is cooking. He's rushed for at least 130 yards in the last four full games he's played. And in the last 2 weeks alone, he's combined for 478 yards and six touchdowns. This week, the Vikings and their top-ranked rushing offense will visit the division rival Bears. Chicago has mostly kept Cook in check so far in his career. In three appearances against the Bears, he averages under 50 total yards and has scored only one total touchdown. Now, this is a different year and a different Cook, but Chicago's defense has been more of the same at fourth overall. They're top seven against both the pass and the run, and they just held Derrick Henry to only 68 yards in Nashville. Now, Minnesota does have the top run-blocking line in the league, but if Chicago is able to hold Cook in check on the ground, that will force the ball into Kirk Cousins' hands, which hasn't been the best game plan for Minnesota this year. Their line is only 25th in pass protection, while the Bears' D-line is 10th in pass rush. The Vikings are only 18th in passing, with Cousins only 17th among quarterbacks. He does, however, have two receivers among the top 15, including the top receiver and rookie Justin Jefferson, and Cook is 9th among backs in receiving. But it'll be tough to keep that going against the Bears' secondary that's number 1 against top receivers, 6th against number 2 wideouts, and 2nd defending passes to running backs. Now, unfortunately for Chicago, though, as good as the defense has been, the offense has been equally bad. The Bears have the 28th ranked offense in the league and are bottom 8 in both passing and rushing, including 2nd to last in the latter. Nick Foles is 27th among quarterbacks, and Chicago doesn't have a receiver in the top 35, including 2 among the bottom 3 in the league. Now, Minnesota's defense hasn't been as bad as you might think. They're around average at 15th overall and around the middle third of the league against both the pass and the run. With the benefit of facing the Bears' anemic offense, they should be able to turn in an above-average performance this week. Despite the Bears sitting at 5-4 and the Vikings at 3-5, Minnesota is 5 spots higher in our power rankings, and they have the advantage on Monday night. Be sure to check out our full pregame analysis and enjoy the game.